Noise, right? And we really hope you enjoy this this first sketch. It's going to be performed by Alistair.
Woo! Here we are with another show, let the Liverpool Review. If you find us funny, please let us know. No, seriously, if you like what you see, you know just what to do. If you think we're shit, go home. Wipe that look off your face, you're in a happy place. And it didn't cost you much to get in. If you think a sketch is finished because I've joked, once in a while our sketches shine, and you could even call them great. But mostly they hit the floor. And usually we're not your cup of tea, and they make you quite irate. But at least we don't say much that's against the law. We've been at this a while, and it really makes us smile, and by now I think we're getting good. Some people say that we're a bit risque, I think we are misunderstood. Be careful not to miss. And if you take distaste to us, or you question the legality of some of our sketches, well, I'm sorry, you haven't a clue. And if you believe that our writing appears to lack originality, it's probably deja vu. And that's not a crime, and we haven't any time for your grievance or any of your beef. If you give us criticism, doesn't matter, we won't listen, we just won't let you in next week.
Where as random as a cheese fondue.
She's hungry. Where as feisting as a kangaroo. Especially if he does come through.
Does come through.
I've heard they're tasty on the barbecue. And they go very well with Danish blue. This analogy has gone askew. Oh shit, I missed the best bit.
Just do it and then end.
Then end it.
Yeah.
Do I'll just go straight to the key change. Key change!
Liverpool Review.
I can take I'll try to sing it in the same tune. Don't worry, the song's nearly through. Now this is the end. Sorry if it drove you round the bend. But if you liked it, could you tell a friend? Seriously. Now this is.
I said no comment. Did you even listen to anything? I don't think you did, you were just pretending. And now you've delayed the finishing. I'm gonna keep singing until I hear a ding. Ding 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 a ding.
I mean, she's gonna be a beautiful butterfly.
Beautiful butterfly.
Beautiful butterfly. And I'm just gonna be an ugly old moth.
Oh, man.
And there ain't no beautiful butterfly that wants to hang out with an ugly old moth.
Gee, don't worry about it. You're too good for her, Woody. You're too good for her.
You're just saying that, Kevin. Oh, here she comes now.
Oh, hey, Christy! Hey, Christy!
Oh, hi, Kevin. Woody.
I hear you think you're gonna be a beautiful butterfly.
Well, my mama was a butterfly, and my sister's a butterfly, and after all, I was the prettiest caterpillar in caterpillar school.
Yeah, and now you're just souped like the rest of us. Jeez, Christy, you're so self-centered and mean.
Well, at least I know how to take care of myself, unlike Hamlet over there.
I was just such a hungry caterpillar. Didn't they write a book about that guy?
I thought it was a movie.
Well, I think it's just such an awful message to teach the little caterpillars. Nutrition is so important. Shame on you, Hamlet. Shame on you.
Well, I just looked at the pretty flowers.
Hey, you know what? I reckon he's gonna be a moth. Yeah, they eat everything. I want to be a moth.
What's that, Kevin?
Don't you want to be beautiful, Kevin?
No, I want to be a moth. Yeah,
My daddy, he was a moth, and his daddy before him, he was also a moth. Yeah, it's in my blood. You know, I want to be a midnight crusader. I want to be a garden vigilante. The garden's guardian. Mothman.
Well, I for one want to be a beautiful butterfly. Then Christy will love me again.
Oh, I'm hatching. Oh, I am a beautiful butterfly. Bye, boys.
Oh, I'm a beautiful butterfly.
Does she have teeth, you know?
No, just fuck the prostitute.
Oh, I get it. I get it, you sick bastard. She's my sister, isn't it? She... Fuck my own sister, and you're probably going to somehow remove my cock to do.
She's not your sister. Just dick her.
I get it now. I've got it. I finally worked it out. I would know why you're doing this.
Just fuck her for the love of God, Robert. Please.
Sorry, please.
Yes. Please. Robert, you're my last chance. No one watches Saw films anymore. My wife has run off with the Paranormal Activity guy. The kids won't speak to me. Nobody's scared of Jigsaw anymore. Just sleep with the prostitute, Robert. This is Saw 12. And sex sells.
Well, Terence, it looks like Mr. Yakamoto swallowed it, if you'll pardon the pun.
Yes, sir. I can't believe he really thought that apple juice was a 100-year-aged whiskey.
Yes, remarkable, isn't it? And good job there, avoiding his daughter's sexual advances.
Yes, the young Miss Yakamoto was positively feral with lust, wasn't she?
Yes. And our efforts today, however haphazard they may have been, have secured this company's future for many years to come. And so now, to toast our success, how about we try some of Mr. Yakimoto's whiskey?
Well, actually, sir...
Terrence. Why isn't Mr. Yakimoto's 100-year-age whiskey in my desk where I asked you to store it?
Well, I suppose you could say the young Miss Yakimoto and I misplaced it.
Terrence!
Hi, sir. I've got the minutes from your meeting with Mr. Yakimoto. Sir. 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 Got a quote for a copier. Sir. Terrence. Bro. Dude. Well, this is rude.
Ooh! Look at me! I'm Captain Nipple Explosion! Oh, I love poo! Oinky doinky doy!
Sorry, it'd be really funny if you came back now and saw me doing this and that'd be really funny. That'd be funny.
Get down to business. I'll just have to get my wrench.
Oh yes, use your wrench.
I will.
I'll just reach into your toolbox and get that for you.
Okay. Were you trying to have sex with me?
Is that not what this is?
You were trying to have sex with me, weren't you?
Yes, yes.
If you wanted someone to have sex with, why did you phone me? A plumber.
Well, as I said on the phone, I need a plumber to plumb my plugs.
You see, that's where you're going wrong. That's not an innuendo.
It's getting real damp downstairs.
You see, not a fix. I got it.
I just need someone to fill my hole.
Now you're not even trying. I'm just going to take my leave if you've got nothing to
do. Oh, look, well, you know, while you're here, I have some work you can do.
Like, actual work. Actual, like, plumbing work.
Actual plumbing work, yes, yes.
Okay, right.
I had Rogue and Josh last night, and if you wouldn't mind, I'm unclogging my U-bend.
Are you referring to scatty anal sex?
Yes.
That's more like it. We're aboard. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this tour's of the afternoon's tour of the marvel of our age. Prepare to be flabbergasted, amazed, and mesmerized. But now, through the wonders of genetics for your amazement and entertainment, your entomazement. Back to life some of the world's most deadly and fascinating organisms.
I can't believe we're here. I've waited so long for this. I've waited so long to come to Giraffe. Did that swing say Bubonic Park?
Welcome to Bubonic Park. Here you'll have the once in a lifetime chance to witness the most devastating effects of some of the world's most horrible, almost extinct, pretty much extinct, diseases. Awesome! Coming up on our right, we have the smallpox paddock. Notice the horrible macules, papules, vesicles, pustules, scabs, and scars that cover the victim's body. Truly magnificent. Coming up now, we're entering the bubonic fields. Here you'll witness the horrors of the Black Death. Wiped out, like, 60% of Europe's population back in the Middle Ages.
What's that cart over there?
It appears to be the bodies of the 2 PM tour. Now would be a great time to don your ponchos. We're about to enter the norovirus enclosure. Oh, it can get messy, but keep them on for later. We're going to be riding the swine flume.
Best day ever! I love diseases!
Oh, okay. Here we come to our last, what do you call it? Enclosure thing? our most popular attraction yet, the polio paddock. Now, look at the poor, poor souls of those inflicted with this horrible disease. In their natural environment, the iron lungs. Oh dear. Oh no, the electricity's gone down! The fences are failing! The machines are opening! Oh, it's horrible! They're sliding out! Luckily, they can't get very far! Oh no, they found the wheelchairs! Wind up the windows! Don't let them seize on you! Oh no, they've woken up all the lepers! Ah, it's horrible! Here we are, back at the visitor centre. Hope you've enjoyed your ride.
That was awesome!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And remember, I hope you got your vaccinations.
Mate, we don't want to get autism.
Anymore.
Not with all that peanut butter in his hair!
Hell yeah! How about we crack a keg and call some babes over?
This is gonna be the best summer ever!
Jack Bradley! Fucking hell!
Word, Rogers.
The iceberg has done considerable damage to our hull. We're taking on gallons of Arctic water. We'll have sunk before we get within range of another ship to signal our distress.
That's a damn shame to hear, Rogers. What of the lifeboats?
Well, the women and the children are safely aboard, sir, as are most of the first class. But, sir, it's like Titanic. She's done for.
Well, Rogers, I suppose all that's left is for the captain to go down on the ship.
Thank you. us. And spaces between us. You have been to show.
You're discharged, seaman.
Next up, meeting Chelsea without the money.
So, shall we go out tonight?
Dunno.
Just like maybe Weatherspoons or something.
Yeah, like I can't really afford it.
Yeah.
I suppose I like just fill up on rice tomorrow or something, and yeah. I can come out like for one.
Yeah, but it's not really worth the bus fare though.
Toads. Was that a parka?
No, just.
Haven't paid the electricity bill?
Yeah, all the heating.
Yeah. It's pretty chill.
I'm so cold, Binky.
Come here then.
Awkward if your boyfriend just walked in now and like totally misconstrued this whole thing and just like went and saved on a bridge or something.
Yeah, not likely though. His parole appeal's turned down.
Oh, fuck. That's not good, Binky.
Yeah.
Sing me to sleep.
Okay. There is a castle on a cloud. I'd like to go there in my sleep. Aren't any floors for me to sweep. There in my castle on a cloud.
You asked for reality TV. You got it. Thank you.
Oh, Jeremy, please take a seat.
Miss Kelly, thank you so much for seeing me.
That's quite a wife. How's your wife?
Oh, she's wonderful, thank you. Yes, she's...
I do apologise, sir. No, the secret life. Embarrassing.
Don't mention it.
Too kind. You were saying about your wife.
Yes, she's recently been made head of our local WI, so she's going to be organising all their guest speakers, their fundraiser. Big sales.
Sorry.
Don't mention it.
Enough chit-chat. What have you come with today?
Oh, well, yes. Okay. Have you ever gotten bored while cleaning? Have you ever felt your environment was too unkempt while you boogie? Introducing the disco mop.
I see. And you're aiming this at housewives.
Pr- primarily, yes, yes.
Jeremy? What are you doing? Watch your step, Jeremy. You don't want to be doing anything inappropriate.
Wouldn't dream of it. So production's relatively inexpensive. We can outsource most of the assembly to the new plant in Afghanistan.
Oh.
What? Oh, come on! I'm soaked!
Oh, I apologize for my disability, Jeremy. I can't spend a working day with a truck strapped to my face, shall I?
No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mrs. Kelly, I should check my prudishness at the door.
We were all new once, Jeremy. It's all right. But I must say that I love, love, love the disco mop. I'd like a prototype on my desk by the end of the month. Oh,
that's amazing. Thank you so much.
It's quite all right. You're a good boy, Jeremy, aren't you? Good boy.
That's the end of the first half.
That's the end of the first half. We're going to go and get a drink.
Go and get a drink. You sucked on. Like you sucked a boat.
Did you enjoy the first?
Yeah! Yes.
Right, little word of warning. We had a little conversation after the last show that it may have been a little bit dark. To which I replied, I told them to turn the lighting up and they didn't. That poem is just a true story. For my own stupidity. But we just want to say it's going to be nothing like that in the second half. In fact, to sort of make up for it, as a university sketch troupe, what we're going to do instead is I'm just going to give you an academic lecture on linguistics. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, George, I hope you don't expect us to show a working knowledge of Grotian implicature. I mean, that wouldn't be bad. It would be awful. As that joke's just proven. So we'll keep it more, you know, layman's wit. And similes, eh? What are they like? Well, at least that bit was original and unlike Heimlich in the first half. but my favourite part of linguistics, I must say, are homophones. And the homophones are, well, a homophone is the Greek word. This is literally a lecture, I'm not going to anywhere else. It's the Greek word for homo, meaning same, right? Phone meaning sound, so you have two things that sound the same but they're different words. It's amazing, like to book, read a book, that's the one, and to book a table, which is confusing in itself because tables are homonym with table as in to table the meeting. It shows that when you study linguistics, you need to know about Greek language because you can't just learn about Latin. A lot of people think it's great, you know, like ring, ring, hello, is that a Latin graduate? Yeah, don't you think it's weird how you have better career prospects than me, an English student, despite the fact you have fewer transferable skills in academic fields? Yes, that's funny.
George, this is bad.
But it's educational.
No, I mean, yeah. Be that as it may, George. The people don't want to see one of your weird meta linguistic pragmatics lectures. They want to see something a bit more normal.
Was it not enough about my penis?
It was both too much and not enough. Right? If you had gone further, it would have been But it was too weird.
They want to see something normal.
Yeah, I'll show them something. I'll do something.
Okay.
Moisturizer. 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 We want to get you moist. It's a crusty, crusty world out there. You gotta defend yourself. You gotta defend your family. Moisture. Moisture. Get moist. Get moist. Buy the moisturizer! Buy the moisturizer! It'll work on anyone! And as I look out on this sea of predominantly white face, exclusively white faces, I want to assure you that it'll work on anyone. We've tested it on multiple skin tones, on every race, so that whoever you are, black, Greek, or Asian, Spanish, or Caucasian, you'll know that this will make you moist, bringing new meaning to the term ethnic cleansing. Moisturizer! If you've got the blemishes, we've got the final solution.
Mr. and Mrs. Fletcher, I want to assure you that we are doing everything we can to find your little daughter, Amy.
Thank you, Detective.
I know she's still out there somewhere. I just know it.
Yes, well, as you can imagine, the most difficult obstacle that we're facing is the fact that she disappeared when she was 12, and she will have aged considerably in the last 5 years.
So even if someone does find her, they might not be able to identify her.
Exactly. However, we have a solution. Back at the office, we've got a computer. It's got software on it. It's photo-aging technology. Now, this allows us to take a picture of Amy as she was and create a projection of how she may look now.
Do you have the image here? Can we see it?
Absolutely.
Oh my God, that's her!
Yeah.
That's our Amy!
Yeah.
This is amazing. She's beautiful, isn't she?
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Hi.
Where will you be putting the photo, Detective?
The photo, I'll tell you what. We're going to be putting the photo in many national newspapers. The Sun, for instance, has taken a...
Sorry, can I say that again? Okay. Uh-huh. I've got a couple of questions.
Yes.
Right, yeah. How did the software decide how she should be dressed? Or rather, undressed?
Well, I wouldn't get hung up on the small details if I were you.
No, of course not. But my concern is that this image is too
heartbreaking.
Hard-making.
I don't understand.
Gee, must you clasp her so scantily?
What do you mean?
Yes, what do you mean, Michael?
She's too sexy! She is far too sexy! She makes this Willy Wiggle something fix!
That is disgusting! What? This is your daughter, Michael! She could be off in some terrorist work camp or some dingy old brothel!
Well, judging by this picture, she's probably in a very upmarket brothel!
Michael! Do you have a boner?
No! Yes, well, no, see? Right, it's not my fault! See, cause why is she licking her finger?
She's probably got
got some whipped cream on it or something?
Why would she have whipped cream on it?
Well, if I had to hazard a guess into my head, I'd say that she, along with all the other abductees, got a bit playful and started rubbing on each other.
Michael, you have to be responsible. This is your daughter. You have to find her. Who's her daddy? Who's her daddy?
I'm the big daddy.
Yes, indeed you are. Now, as I was saying, we're going to get this on a full page spread in the somewhere near the beginning.
How near the beginning?
Oh, pretty close. A couple of pages in. Somewhere between pages 2 and pages 4.
No, they're not doing page 3 anymore as of today. They've cancelled it. Yes, they've ripped a national institution out from underneath us. What am I going to do in the mornings now without my daily tits? It's just not fair. But you know what they are printing? They're printing missing person ads. I don't think they care about your lost little Amy anymore. You know what they do care about? Tits. So, you've got a very good chance of finding her if you have her as a half-naked person in the sun. There's a very good chance of exposure. So you've got to make a decision. You can decide between a win-win situation where you find your little daughter Amy and everything's happy and you leave the nation with a nice, gentle fix of a thrill and a spill. Or you find the lose-lose situation where you don't find your daughter Amy and you leave her in a rotting, smelly dungeon and leave the nation in a state of sadness and floppiness.
Oh, disgusting. We're leaving. Come on, Michael.
Damn you! Damn you!
Russian lad as you seem to be. another thing, don't happen to have any disabilities at all, any physical or otherwise, that might be impairing your judgment?
No, not.
Ever thought about rogering a bloke?
Goodness! Golly, I don't know what that has to do with anything.
Well, I'll set the scene for you. You could be driving down this icy road with a healthy amount of 50% blood alcohol in your blood. And all of a sudden, you're up in danger about sucking massive cocks.
I don't really see what that's got
yes, to do. Big, lovely, veiny cocks. Hard to focus on the road when you're imagining a throbbing member between your torn butt cheeks.
No. He's the straightest, most butchest, most red-blooded male around. Even his elbows have chill steel.
Don't worry, lad. I believe you. Ever worn lingerie?
No.
Lace panties, stockings, or even a little corset just for the thrill?
No.
After check, I'm afraid, my boy. Being a Nancy boy is now officially a disease in the motherland. Yeah, I had to put away my stiletto boots if I wanted to keep this badge. Shame. I like being tossed boy. I skip the weekends.
That's funny.
I know, I thought of it myself. Yes, I'm afraid Conrad Putin and his chums reckon that, you know, if you, well, they reckon that if you're a baddie boy, then you can't bloody drive, can you now? Bloody crash, that's what will happen.
That's really of them.
Yeah, I mean, like, just, you're all thinking about things like satin and cocks. Mum, why don't you take the wheel, otherwise this loony over here might get you killed.
Actually, yeah.
That's something I'm not planning to forget my whole drive home. Shit.
Apologising to him. I love him with all my heart. I just want to come home.
Well, in that case, we're going to speak at the start country again. Come hug your mummy.
I invited him over for tea, if that's okay. Invited him out for tea. Have to say, nothing like you described him. Jesus, silly.
Sorry, what?
Jesus is coming round for tea. Come on in, babe.
It's a bit more silly.
See, such a dick. Sorry, babe. Always apologising to him. It's okay. Oh, no, yeah. Can see why you're repenting all the time. Can't get his name right either. What?
Jesus.
Well,
Jesus.
Oh,
get out of my house! No!
Look, that is no way to treat a dress. Guess not.
That is not our Lord and Saviour, Jesus!
He is a landed member of the gentry, and he has the documents to prove it.
He's the Jesus who died for our sins.
My my roots were a sin, and he dyed those perfectly.
Miracles?
Did a miracle with my split ends?
So his mother was called Mary?
Yes.
And she was a virgin?
Yes. Genuine product of IVF. Lesbian parents, it's a marvellous age.
Enough of this sinful nonsense. I want you to get down onto your knees and beg Jesus for forgiveness.
Zeus.
Thank you. He's not Jesus Christ. What's his surname?
Escobar.
His surname's not even Christ.
Christ's a nickname.
How would you get the nickname Christ?
Babe.
Oh, Jesus Christ!
Jesus!
Hey, we did a sketch! So, I know you've noticed, you've all noticed, we do a lot of sketches about Christianity, and I don't want to give you the wrong impression that we have some sort of vested vendetta against the church, because we don't. And the truth is that we really don't want to discriminate. And to the end of not discriminating, we're going to perform a sketch for you now entitled Silly Sikhs. It'll be fine, don't worry. If you guys want to come on stage? The place was India, Punjab to be specific. The year was 1969. And all the Sikhs from far and wide had come to hear Guru Gobind speak.
And that is why you should be no. Nice to me. Okay. No. And that is why you should be nice to people.
Wow!
I would never have known that otherwise.
You are so clever, Guru Gobind.
I once turned a dog inside out.
He's right, you should be nice to people.
Yes. And on that note, I need a head.
Pardon?
I need a head. God needs a head for his purposes. Any volunteers?
But I thought he was against violence and everything.
This just in from God. Shut up, Saeed.
I'm it.
Excellent. And why will you do it?
Because you told me to.
Outstanding. If you'll just come with me into my tent, I'll remove your head off of the rest of you.
Yay!
Yeah, so the other day, there was a little dog inside my tandoor, and I just jumped on it and shoved my thumbs.
It is right. Done! See the blood that drips from my knife and know that your brother is now one with the Almighty God.
What a lad!
Yes, sir. What a lad. Golly, but wish I could have done that for God. I am jealous of old Dara.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. You're what an honour.
Well, I'm afraid God needs another head. God needs another head. No, just because. So, take it, you volunteer.
Well now, given all that stuff I just said, it'd be pretty damn capricious of me to not let you assist my suicide.
Very capricious indeed, Darren. So, you can either keep your head and look rather silly, or you can give it to God and look like an absolute baller. Which one will it be?
Well, you know, the second one? The baller one?
Good man, let's go.
Yeah, so anyway, I jumped on him from behind, or doggy style, if you will. And I just got my thumbs and went right down.
It is done! Again!
God needs another head.
Me! Me! Love me!
Go on, get in there, little scamp.
Just shove my thumbs right up to the doggy bum hole. And it was that easy part, but you know, if you want to do it properly, you don't have to not be
bring out your heads!
I was just telling my puppyception story.
Nobody cares if you're mad. Nobody actually likes you.
Well, in that case, this will hit a couple birds at one stone, won't it? So.
Well, I don't want to be alone, do I?
Ha ha! Remaining Sikhs! You are all fools! They are not dead! This is merely pig's blood, you see? Look! And here is the lesson. You all failed the test! Losers! Losers!
Losers! Losers! Losers!
There is a lesson to be learned here. God doesn't want live human sacrifices as a test of faith. No! Here he wanted to make himself feel like a big shot. At the end of the day, deities are just like us and feel very powerful when they get given head.
Knock, knock! What's that?
It's bone cancer in kids!
Hello! I'm your donation to help us save all the kids from bone cancer. Would you care to donate?
Yeah, but what are you doing?
I'm collecting for charity.
Yeah, no, but what are you doing? What do you want me to give you money for?
Well, the kids. They've all got bone cancer.
Yeah, but are you taking a bath of beans, or like running a marathon dressed as a giant bee, or like staying awake for 24 hours?
No, I'm collecting for charity.
So you're not even making the effort to come into work in casual clothes?
There's no time for that. You cut these kids and they bleed. Tumors.
Okay, I suppose my question is, what are you going to do to make it more worth my while? I mean, like bone cancer in kids is all well and good, but it's just poor salesmanship not to sweeten the pot.
Sweeten the pot?
You know, grease the chorizo, mate! Spices on the gumbo!
The gumbo?
Entertain me! Otherwise it's too easy!
But why?
Do a dance.
What?
Dance for me! Oh, no. Don't you care about the kids? Dance!
I'm collecting for charity.
If you don't dance, you're pro-cancer. Oh. Do the dance, Biatch.
Okay.
Love it when they do something wacky. Love it when they watch Groundhog Day on a loop for 24 hours. Love it when they put a nose on their nose. Love that shit. Yeah. That was great, but I don't have any change, and I don't want to break a tenner. So, yeah.
I just need to tell them it's okay. Mr. and Mrs. Fletcher, thank you for seeing me again.
You heard us the last time with all that page 3 nonsense, but we've been assured you're the best in the business, so you're our best shot at finding little Amy and bringing her home, then let's put all that behind us.
I'm glad. This time I want to assure you I've worked on focusing on creating and generating an image that accurately represents your daughter this time.
And there'll be no funny business, no excessively sexy nipple daughters.
No, absolutely not. No, in fact, this time I've taken into account a myriad of different factors, including the condition of her disappearance, the way in which you two grew up when you were at her age, but most importantly, the time that's elapsed since she was last seen.
Do you have an accurate image this time?
Absolutely.
Detective. That's a skeleton.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Oh, I'm pretty sure you do, Mrs. Fletcher. It's been 5 years since your daughter was last seen. This is probably what she looks like right now. Unless, of course, she was cremated. Yes, cremated, Mr. Fletcher. It's a process in which you burn the body after death, usually to ash, presumably to get rid of the evidence.
We are leaving!
Damn you! Damn you!
You sure?
guy over here. Who's like, no! And then... You ready, Thelma?
Yeah.
I'm ready, Louise. And then they kiss. I don't think we need to do that. And they hold hands.
That one hits the accelerator.
Ah!
Good boy.
That's us. That's us. Lois Riley, Madeline Smart, Gennard Williams, and Liam Hale. Thank you all. and we'd also like to thank 81 Renshaw Street. Yay!